Today, we can start with a new chapter, Journal. Accounting process starts from this chapter. Now, let us study what is a journal. Journal is a book of accounts in which all day-to-day transactions are recorded in a chronological order. That is, in the order of dates. Transactions when recorded in the journal are known as entries. So, you can say it as a journal entry. Journal is also known as book of original record or book of primary entry. For recording transactions in the journal, business transactions are classified. Business transactions can be classified as assets, liabilities, capital, revenue, and expenses. At this point of time, you should know what are the assets, liabilities, capital, revenue, and expense. So, let us study that. Cost incurred by a business in the process of earning revenue are known as expenses. Rent paid can be said as an expense. Interest paid is an expense. Similarly, what is capital? The amount invested in the business by the owner can be called as a capital. It may be in the form of money or assets having value. Now, let us study what are assets. Assets are things having certain value which are owned by the business. That is, anything which will enable the firm to get cash in the future. Liabilities means the obligations of the business towards outsiders. That is, amount payable by the business to the outsiders can be called as liability. What is revenue? Revenue is the inflow of assets which results in the increase in the capital. We can include rent received as a revenue, commission received also as a revenue. And now, we have to follow certain rules while recording. Accounts are debited or credited according to the rules of debit and credit. What is journalizing? The process of recording transactions in the journal is known as journalizing. Small business houses maintain one journal book. Big business houses have large number of transactions. So, journal is divided into various types of books called special journals. In special journal, transactions are recorded depending upon the nature of transaction. That is, all credit sales are recorded in the sales book. All cash transactions are recorded in cash book. All credit purchases are recorded in purchases book. Similarly, we have so many books like bills receivable book and bills payable book. Now, in the slide, you can see the format of a journal. Here, every page of the journal has a particular format as given in the slide. It is a columnar book. That is, each column is given a name, date, particulars, ledger folio, debit amount, and credit amount are the columns in the journal. Now, we have to know how we have to write the date column. In the date column, we record the date of the transactions with its accounting year and the month. We write year only once at the top. Year will not be repeated with every date. In the particulars column, the accounts affected by a transaction are recorded. Here we have to write the account which has to be debited on the first line. In the extreme right of the same line, you have to write DR, That is, it is the short form of debit. In the second line, the account which has to be credited is written. This account has to be started with the preposition to. In the third line of an entry, narration for that particular entry must be made. Narration should be short, complete and clear. After every journal entry, horizontal line is drawn in the particulars column. This is done to separate one entry from the other. Next, we have ledger folio column. Transactions entered in the journal is posted to the ledger. In the ledger folio column, we write the page number of the ledger where the account is posted. Next, we have debit amount column. In this column, the amount to be debited is written against the same line in which the debited account is written. And in the last column, we have credit amount column. In this column, the amount to be credited is written against the same line in which the credited account is written. Total of both these columns should be equal. Why it should be equal? Because the same amount is entered in the debit and in the credit columns in all the entries. And the totals are carried forward to the next page with the words total carried forward. At the top of the next page in the particulars column, we write totals brought forward. The amount of totals is written in the respective amount column. Now, we have to do the process of writing the journal in the journal entry, and that is known as journalizing. So, let us study the steps for performing the preparation of a journal. Following are the steps taken for the preparation of the journal. For that, first we have to identify the accounts of an accounting transaction. For example, if the transaction is goods worth rupees 10,000 are purchased for cash, then purchases account and cash account are the two affected accounts. As a next step, we have to recognize the type of accounts. In the same transaction which I just mentioned, that is goods worth rupees 1000 are purchased for cash, we have to identify the group to which the affected accounts belong. That is, we are identifying the type of account. Earlier, I have taught you that the business transactions are classified as assets, liabilities, expense, revenue and capital. On this basis, we have to classify this transaction. That is, purchases account will be considered as an expense and cash account will be considered as an asset. Then next procedure is apply the rules of debit and credit. Rules of debit and credit are applied to the affected accounts. Asset account and expenses account will be debited if there is an increase. Asset account and expenses account will be credited if there is a decrease. Liability, capital and revenue are debited if there is a decrease. Liability, capital and revenue accounts are credited if there is an increase. In the above example, when goods are purchased, expenses are increasing. So, purchases account will be debited. When payment is made in cash, assets decrease. So, cash account is credited. Now, the journal entry will be recorded in the journal. Now, let us study the rules once again. It is shown in your PPT. See, liability will be debited when it is decreasing and liability will be credited when it is increasing. Assets will be debited when it is increasing. Assets will be credited when it is decreasing. expenses will be debited when it is increasing and credited when it is decreasing. Income will be debited when it is decreasing and credited when it is increasing. Capital will be debited when it is decreasing and credited when it is increasing. Journal entry will be made in the journal along with a brief explanation, that is known as narration. The corresponding amounts will be written in the debit and credit columns. After completing one entry, a horizontal line is drawn before entry for the next transaction is made in the journal. Now let us analyze the transaction that is given in the PPT. First transaction that is given is on January 1st, cash received from the owner Tarun. Here we have to identify which are the main accounts that is affected. That is cash and capital. Cash is received from the owner, so cash is coming inside the business, so cash is one account. And it is coming in the form of capital, so that is also another affected account, that is capital. Which are the kinds of account to which you can allot these cash and capital? You can consider this cash under asset account and capital and under capital account. Then you have to identify whether there is an increase or decrease. Yes, in this transaction, that is cash received from the owner, here cash is coming inside, cash is increasing. Capital is also increasing. So, when applying the rules, cash account is debited and capital account is credited. Then coming to the second date, that is January 2nd, goods purchased for cash. Goods are coming inside the business, so the affected accounts are goods and cash is going from the business, so cash. Goods and cash are the affected accounts. So, under which type of account these will come? Goods will come under expense. As a purchases, it is an expense. Cash will come under asset account. So, goods are increasing, whether it is an increase or decrease, then we have to think in that form. Goods are increasing or purchases are increasing. Cash is going from the business when you purchase the goods. So, cash is decreasing. So, how will you write the entry or which account is to be debited or credited? That is, purchases account will be debited and cash account will be credited. And when you move to the January 4th transaction, machinery purchased on credit from Vipu. Vipu is the creditor. We didn't pay the money on that particular date. We will make the payment on a future date. So, this is a credit transaction. So, the creditor's name should be included. So, machinery and Vipu are the two affected accounts. Machinery will come under asset account and Vipu being a creditor, that will be a liability for the business. Machinery will increase. Machinery is purchased when you consider the business organization. Machinery is coming inside, so it is an increase to the business. Creditor, that is liability, is also an increase. So, you will debit machinery account and Vipu's account is credited. Asset account, increase means it will be debited. Liability, increase means it will be credited. So, Vipu's account is credited. Coming to the next transaction, January 6th. Rent paid in cash. Rent and cash are the two affected accounts. Rent will come under expense. Cash will come under asset. Rent paid, that is expenses increasing. Rent being an expense account, it is increasing. Cash is going from the business, so cash is decreasing. So, when you consider the rule, rent being an expense is increasing. When expenses increase, you have to debit. So, rent account is debited. Cash is decreasing. When asset account is decreasing, cash is credited. So, rent account will be debited and cash account will be credited. Now, moving to January 8th. goods purchased on credit from Anil. Here the two affected accounts are purchases and Anil. Anil is a creditor. Purchases being an expense, it will come under main account, that is expense. Purchases will come under expense account. Anil, the creditor, can be considered as a liability. Purchases increases, goods are purchased on credit from Anil. That means purchases increases. So when purchases increases means purchases account is debited. Being an expense account, all expenses when increase, it will be debited. Anil is a liability. It is purchased on credit. That is, we did not make the payment on that particular date. So Anil's account, Anil being a liability, is increasing. So when liability increases, Anil's account is credited. So purchases account is debited and Anil's account is credited. So moving to the next transaction, that is on January 10th, goods sold for cash. Two affected accounts are cash and sales. Cash is coming inside the business. When goods are sold, cash will come inside the business. So cash is an account and sales, goods are going outside. When goods are going outside means we will consider it under a head known as sales account. When goods are coming inside, that is, we will consider it under purchases account. When goods are going outside, we will consider it under sales account. And cash will come under the main heading asset. Sales will come under the main heading revenue. It is an income. So cash is increasing. When goods are sold, cash is coming inside. So cash is increasing. So rule, as an asset, when increases, it will be debited. So cash account is debited. And sales, goods are sold for cash. So sales, it will be the account to be credited. Why it is credited? Because it is an income that is increasing. Revenue that is increasing. Rule for revenue is when it increases, we have to credit. So sales account is credited. Moving to the next transaction, that is on January 15th, credit sales to Gurmeet. Goods are sold to Gurmeet. Gurmeet is a debtor. And sales is the aspect. So two accounts, Gurmeet's account and sales account. Gurmeet is a debtor, so it will come under asset account. Sales is a revenue, and when asset increases, that is debtor increases, you have to debit that account. When revenue increases here, as a result of sales, income is increasing, so sales account is credited. So the entry will be Gurmeet's account debit to sales account. Moving to the next transaction, that is on January 18th, salaries paid in cash. Two affected accounts are salaries and cash. Salaries will come under expense. Cash will come under asset. Salaries increases, that is expense increases. And cash is going outside the business. When you pay the salary, cash will go outside the business, that is cash will decrease. So when the expense increases, that expense account is debited, that is salary account will be debited. And asset, that is cash is decreasing, so cash account is credited. When asset decreases, we have to credit that account. When expense increases, we have to debit that account. So salaries account will be debited and cash account will be credited. Moving to the next transaction date, January 20th. Cash withdrawn for personal use by the owner. Two affected accounts are drawings account and cash. Drawings means the amount withdrawn by the owner for his own personal use. That is the amount that is taken from the capital. So it is affecting which main account? That is affecting the capital account. And cash is going from the business. Cash will come under which account? That is the asset account. So drawings will decrease the capital and asset as a cash. Cash is going, so cash will also decrease and drawings will also decrease, that is capital will decrease. So drawings account will be debited and cash account is credited. When asset decreases, cash account is credited. When capital decreases, drawings account will be debited. So we have studied how to write the entries in the transaction, in the journal.